This series is funded by fans like you.
Oh, and when do your classes begin?
Next month.
That's just when Fatima comes back to work, isn't it?
Yeah. So the agreement is if I want to be Ollie's full-time nanny, then I have to finish high school first.
You really love taking care of Ollie, don't you?
I do. Like, more than I ever expected. I never thought I'd want kids. Well, I guess I still don't, but taking care of Ollie is, like, the best thing I've ever done.
That sounds great. You've found something you're passionate about.
Yeah. Before that, I was only ever really good at school, and, well, then I dropped out, so.
So how do you feel about having, as you say, dropped out?
Well, I still think it was the best idea for me. But I don't know. All my friends have graduated, or they're about to if they did Super 12.
Sorry, Super 12?
Oh, it's like a victory lap. You do grade 12 again to try and bump up your grades.
Oh, you mean like grade 13?
Yeah, that's what my dad calls it.
So how do you feel about your friends having graduated or about to graduate then?
Oh, it's weird. I was always the person that they came to for help. I had the top marks in math and science. And hey, there's this one girl. She was really smart too, but she could just not figure out chemistry. I really liked tutoring her. But her and all my other friends, they're about to go to university. Or they might have started already. I don't know. I haven't even finished grade 11. I feel behind.
Mm-hmm. Well, how does it feel being behind?
It's embarrassing. Or I'm ashamed. I don't know. I just keep thinking about Mrs. Hoyt. She was my favorite teacher. She said when she was a student, all her teachers would ask her, "Why are you taking math? Why even bother? You're a girl." She said even the head of her math department told her she should switch into home ec. But she didn't do that. She overcame all of that...
Sexism?
Yeah, yeah. And she became a math teacher. And then there's me. I'm good at math and I'm good at science, but I dropped out. It's just a waste.
So why do you feel you're wasting your math and science skills when you're going back to school?
Well, it's not really school. It's like online.
Sounds like you're being hard on yourself again, Vanessa.
Okay. I don't know if I want to do math and science anymore.
Why is that?
It's actually something you helped me realize. I love taking care of Ollie. He's already almost one, and he's just so smart, and he's so curious about the world, and a small part of me feels like I had something to do with that. He's gonna take his first steps any day now, I just know it. Anyway, I just feel like that's what I'm supposed to be doing with my life.
Doing what?
I don't know. Like, something to do with children? I just see how important it is that they have good first steps in life. But that has nothing to do with math. Other than teaching them math, but that's not what I mean. I mean little kids. It's just so different.
You know, Vanessa, it sounds like you have some really great goals right now, and you're making good progress towards them. So why is it you sound so unsure?
There's just been so much change. I always thought I was a normal girl who got good grades, who was going to go to university for math and science, who was going to get married to a man, and that I'd be expected to have kids because that's what my parents would want, but I'm none of those things. I find out I'm not even straight, I'm bisexual, and I didn't even know what that meant. I dropped out of high school, so I can't go to university, and I don't want kids. I just feel like I'm betraying everything I ever believed in.
Okay, who are you betraying then?
Well, me.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I feel like I had this plan, and I just abandoned it. And so then I'm letting myself down, and I'm letting down all these women before me who didn't have the same opportunities as me. I'm just flushing it all down the drain.
Okay, well, that's a lot of responsibility that you put on yourself, and not to mention all the womankind as well.
I don't know. Maybe I'm just in shock. I'm not used to it yet. I liked math. Like, I kind of miss it. But what's the point in taking it if I'm going to go into childcare?
You know, you remind me of another client I have. And she wanted to be a chef and own her own restaurant when she grew up. She wanted that from a really young age. So she went to school for culinary arts. Got a degree, whole bit, business planning. But then she got a job working at City Hall. And she became a civil servant in the city planning department. Surprise, surprise, she loves it.
Wow.
Her career now has nothing to do with making food. And I'm sure, just like you, there was a time she felt that those years of school were a total waste. But that was over 20 years ago. And now she finds great fulfillment doing what she does. And she still loves to cook. So for you, caring for children might not be the path you originally dreamed of. But Vanessa, dreams, they can change. And when they do, it's kind of like they died. And that means you actually need to mourn them. And that's okay. It's totally normal. But this new path doesn't make you happy.
Yeah, it does. I don't know. I guess I just never saw myself, like, working with kids. The old me would have been, she wouldn't believe it.
Yeah, I bet. But this is the beginning of a new adventure. And you know what? Who knows? You might find your way back to math and sciences later on in life.
Maybe.
Oh, sorry. It looks like we ran a little late today, actually.
Oh.
It's been feeling fast often lately, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It's because we're getting so much done in each session.
It feels like we are.
So I'll see you next week at our usual time?
Yeah, thanks for seeing me at a different time.
Oh, absolutely no problem. I hope you don't mind. You might pass my next client in the waiting room. He's usually pretty early.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay. All right. Bye, Vanessa.
Thanks.
Vanessa.